Hello students, welcome to the channel of Vedant classes. So in this lecture we are going to see that how to draw an ellipse by an arc of circle method. Okay, so first of all, draw a major axis of a given length like this, then draw a minor axis of given length CD. Okay, then what you need to do, you just need to find the focus. So how you can find the focus? Now see, from C, point C, you just need to put arc over here and over here. So this will be your F1 and this will be your F2. Now see, CF1 will be equal to CF2 and that will be equal to half of AB. So the dimension will be equal to OA, or you can say OB, but that will be equal to half of major axis. Okay. So from C you just need to put an arc like this and like this. Okay, so let's see. So like that you can get an F1 and point F2. Now what you need to do, you just need to divide OF1, you just need to divide the length OF1 into various parts. Okay, so divide it like this, 1 2 3 F4. Okay, now see what you need to do. Just take the dimension equal to A1, okay? Take the dimension equal to A1 and put the arc like this. Then take the dimension from B21, okay? Take dimension from B21. Then put your rounder at F2 and put arc and make an arc. Cut it like this, okay? So here you will get a point. Same thing you need to do at the lower part, okay? So you just need to carry on, then take a distance A2, then put it at F1 and put an arc over here. Then take distance equal to B2, then from F2 put arc like this. Same thing you just need to do at the bottom part. Okay. So keep going like this, you will get various points. Okay. You will get various points like this. So let's see how to make an arc. So see, A1 with focus as a center, you just need to make an arc. Then from F2, okay, so at top and bottom you need to make arc. Then from F2 you need to consider the distance equal to B1. So from B2 1, this much distance you need to take, and from F2 you just need to put an arc. Okay, so you'll get your point. Then at bottom you need to make an arc, you'll get your points. So likewise, this distance will be equal to A2, okay, and this distance will be equal to B2. So likewise you can get your points. This will be A3 B3, this will be for A4 B4, as F1 and F2 as center. Okay, so on the other side you just need to carry on the same thing. Okay, just keep taking the arcs and keep marking the points. Okay, so one by one you will get all such points. Now what you need to do, you just need to join all the points like this. If you will join the points, you will get a ellipse. Okay, as you can see it here on your screen. Okay, so now if you want to make a tangent out of the ellipse at any point, let's say at P2 we want to make a tangent, then what you need to do, just draw a bisector, just draw a bisector like this. So this will be your normal line, and from normal line if you take a tangent, okay, if you draw a tangent, so this is how you can draw a tangent and normal to the given point. Okay, so let's see how we can proceed. Just draw a bisector, so that will be a normal. Okay, and at 90 degree you will get a tangent. Okay, so this is how you can make an ellipse and draw a tangent and normal at any point. Okay, okay, now let's see one problem. The distance between two coplanar fixed point is 100 mm. So in that, the distance is given between two fixed points is 100 mm. So that means the distance between F1 and F2 is 100 mm. Okay, the distance between these two points is 100 mm that is given in the question. Okay, to trace the complete path of point G moving in same plane in such a way that the sum of distance from the fixed point is always 140 mm. So see, here it is given that sum of the distance from the fixed point is always 140 mm. So that remains constant. And if it is remaining constant, it means that we need to use the arc of circle method. Okay. So question is of arc of circle method, and the curve that we'll get is ellipse. We'll get an ellipse in this case. Okay. So here it is not given that you just need to draw an ellipse. Okay. So you just need to read the question, understand the meaning sense of the question, and then you just need to carry on the steps. Okay, now let's solve the question. So in the question, they have given the distance between two foci, that is F1 and F2. Okay, which is equal to 100 mm. Okay, which is equal to 100 mm. Now see, let's consider any point G which lies on the ellipse. So according to the question, GF1 plus GF2 is equal to 140 mm. So this will be equal to the length of major axis, and this shows that the curve will be ellipse. Okay, because it is the definition of ellipse. So the length of major axis is 140 mm. So let's say we are having the major axis like this, and length of this major axis is 140. Name it as point A and point B, and here the center it will be O. Okay. Now let's see how to draw a minor axis, because length of minor axis is not given in the question. Now see, we know that consider the CD as a minor axis, so C to F1 will be equal to half of AB. Okay, C to F1 will be equal to half of AB. So that is equal to, you can say half of AB will be equal to 70. Okay, so just put the rounder at F1 and mark a point over here having radius 70 mm. Okay, considering radius. Same thing apply from F2. So it will be like this. Okay, same thing, you just need to apply from F2. Okay, at the bottom part, repeat the same process like this, and when you will join this one, so you will get your point C and D. So this CD will be your minor axis. So this is how you can obtain the length of minor axis. Okay, so now let's see the procedure. So first of all, draw F1 and F2 of length 100 mm. Okay. Then give the point G dash. Okay, you just need to draw a perpendicular. Now see, GF1 plus GF2, which is equal to the major axis of 140 mm. So draw the major axis. Now what you need to do, you just need to mark the points C and D. Okay, here it is given as G and G dash. So taking a radius R equal to 70 mm that we have seen. Okay, just mark the points, so you will get your minor axis. Now what you need to do, you just need to divide the length OF1 into equal parts like this. Okay, now what you need to do, you just need to open your rounder from, okay, open your compass from A to 1, and putting it F1, you just need to make an arc on both the side. Then you just need to open your compass till B21 and mark it from F2 like this. So you'll get your points. Okay, you'll get your points here like this. Okay, so like this, you just need to make arc from F2. You just need to take a distance equal to B1. Okay, so this is how it follows. You just need to keep making an arc. So if you will keep making an arc like this, you will get the successive points. Okay, when you get all the points, you just need to join all these points, so you get an curve which is called as ellipse. Okay, so this is how you can make an ellipse. So that's it from this lecture. So please like, subscribe and share the channel if you are finding it helpful. Thank you so much.